During the 2012 AAPEX show in Las Vegas, Mark Tseng with the marketing and global forecasting company Polk presented five trends in 5 minutes, trends affecting the aftermarket environment. The presentation touched on everything from OEMs to the economy's impact on the aftermarket.
Trend number one, OEMs are becoming much more aggressive and competitive as light vehicle sales recover. We're seeing a nice, steady recovery in vehicle sales. We'll take a look at that in detail here in a second, but at the same time, the OEMs are becoming much more aggressive. We're seeing it in marketing programs, and pricing strategies, and incentives out there, and it's really interesting what's happening with the players. And really, we see the playing field as being much more healthy, much more level. The hard impact of the recession is behind us. The natural disasters, the impact of the tsunami and the earthquake are behind us, and the key OEMs in the United States are in as good or better position than they have ever been. And we really see them making a comeback and helping to drive those new vehicle sales as the new vehicle sales recover. And they're really going after the consumer's attention as they enter the showrooms once again. Trend number two, the vehicle population continues to age. Vehicle demographics and vehicle statistics continue to turn and change in the favor of the aftermarket. There are simply more vehicles on the road that will be typically repaired in the independent aftermarket channel than anywhere else, than at any other time in history. Let's take a look at that. When you look at average age of vehicles stands now at about 11.3 years total. Over the last 10 years, when you look at cars alone, they've increased 14%. Light trucks have increased 17% over that time frame. That brings us to trend number three. CUVs and mid-sized cars are driving the recovery in new vehicle sales. Obviously, the average age of the vehicle, the different things that are going on with the age and the number of vehicles that are in the different population groups, certainly having impact on what vehicles we will see come back to the aftermarket. But when you take a look down in the new vehicle and the new registrations that are driving this recovery, it's very interesting to see which cars and light trucks are the winners, because that'll be what we see in our bays in the years to come. Okay, trend number four, globalization of platforms and model families is accelerating. The use of the OEMs, the use of platforms within the OEMs has been an ongoing trend for a number of years, making more and more models and units off of a single platform, but we're seeing this trend accelerate. We're seeing a lot more models and facelifts and redesigns being introduced. Talked about the OEMs and how aggressive they're getting, and we think this trend is going to do nothing but accelerate. That brings us to the final trend, trend number five. Technologically advanced vehicles, we believe, offer increasing aftermarket opportunity. I've talked in the past, if you've been to any of these five and fives in the past, about how the OEMs really see the benefit and the profit and the top line revenue opportunity there is in going after aftermarket business. Obviously, as light vehicle sales took a hit, they were looking to make up that profit somewhere. They've become very aggressive in the aftermarket, and they're using technology as one means to do that. Obviously, a lot of this technology being introduced, don't get me wrong, for driver convenience and connectivity and things like that, but there are other things that if we as an independent aftermarket aren't aware of and embrace, could put us in a bad position